हेलो दोस्तों, वेलकम टू लिखो स्टेनो एकेडमी। दोस्तों, डेली डिक्टेशंस के लिए और आपके डाउट्स के सॉल्यूशंस के लिए इस चैनल को अभी सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल आइकन प्रेस करें ताकि आपको चैनल से जुड़ी सभी अपडेट्स रेगुलरली सबसे पहले मिल सके। दोस्तों, पिछले वीडियो मैंने आपको प्रोवाइड की थी इसी मैटर की 100 वर्ड पर मिनट पर, और इस वीडियो में मैं आपको डिक्टेशन दूंगा 80 वर्ड पर मिनट की। सो 800 वर्ड्स की डिक्टेशन है और 80 वर्ड पर मिनट इसकी स्पीड होगी। आपको डिक्टेशन दे रहा हूँ, बी रेडी फॉर इट। ऑनरेबल स्पीकर, आई एम वेरी ग्रेटफुल टू यू फॉर अलाउविंग मी टू पार्टिसिपेट ऑन ए वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड क्रिटिकल बिल which has come before this august house. I am sure this bill will mark a beginning of a new era in the field of information revolution. Sir, all modern societies, or any society for that matter, will require a strong and purposeful government to steer them. In our own country, the government expenditure accounts for nearly 30% of our gross national product, both at the central level and at the level of states and local bodies. At the same time, we find that social and economic imperatives require our government to intervene in all economic and social affairs. Therefore, I feel that the efficiency and effectiveness of governmental processes are the critical variables. This will determine how we are functioning and to what extent we are able to discharge the responsibilities entrusted to us by our electorate. Sir, as far as power of the government is concerned, I have always believed that it is the sacred trust that the society has given to the government. We, as a part of the government, have to spend in taking into account the good of the largest number of people. Therefore, it becomes all the more obligatory on our part to see that there is right correlation between the expenditure and efficiency. It is a common knowledge that we all talk about wastefulness of expenditure and about corruption prevailing in our system. Hence, it is very important for us to explore new and effective mechanism to ensure that we all do our duties with a sense of responsibility. This is the guiding spirit behind this right to information bill that is now under consideration of this August House. Sir, now the question comes as to what is the secret of successful functioning of any democratic institution. In my view, the key to the successful functioning of any democratic polity lies in the ability of a citizen to observe and evaluate the functioning of their elected representatives. The common man should be able to make an informed judgment about the performance of their elected representatives. This is possible only if there is an easy availability of necessary information for a citizen to arrive at a decision. Then we have got the system to checks and balances at different levels. This system has made all of us proud of our ability to match the goal of economic development. In this context, I would say that it is the common man and the common woman of this country who is the focal point of our democratic system. He or she is the seeker of information and the final judge of our performance. This government, sir, has made a commitment not only to work for the welfare of the common man, but also to strengthen his or her role as the architect of our destiny. It is in this background that today we are discussing this right to information bill in this house. This is possible only when our institutions function in a transparent, responsive, and accountable manner. The right to information bill, sir, will bring into force another right that will empower the citizen in this regard. This will bring into effect a critical right for enforcing other rights. This will also provide an opportunity to fill a vital gap in this regard. The bill under consideration is more far-reaching and effective. I am very grateful to all concerned for having played a very important role in bringing into focus major drawbacks in the legislation. The present bill has the widest possible reach, covering the central government, the state governments, panchayati raj institutions, local bodies, and so on. This bill talks about access of information, which is simple, easy, time-bound, and inexpensive. It has provided for certain stringent penalties for failing to provide information in any way. In fact, the bill has imposed certain obligations on agencies and organizations to disclose information. Sir, one of the important features of the present bill is the independent appeal mechanism through the appointment of central and state information commissioners. This mechanism has made the right a potent instrument for good governance. Sir, here I would like to say that many honorable members have raised many concerns and questions during the course of discussion on this bill. I would only like to say that everyone should see the bill in a positive spirit and not as a draconian law for the purpose of paralyzing the government. This is an instrument for improving the relationship between the government and its citizens so that it becomes a friendly, caring, and effective government functioning for the good of our people. I hope that this would be used towards better performance. दोस्तों इसी के साथ ही डिक्टेशन फिनिश होती है. 80 वर्ड पर मिनट की डिक्टेशन थी. अपनी मिस्टेक्स निकालिए, कमेंट सेक्शन में मुझे बताइए मिस्टेक्स आपकी कितनी आ रही हैं, और तैयार रहिए अगले लाइव सेशन के लिए. कोशिश करेंगे कि इसी वीक में हम एक दूसरा लाइव सेशन और करें. सो आपसे मुलाकात करता हूँ अगली क्लास में अगले ट्रांसक्रिप्शन के साथ. तब तक के लिए बाय बाय, टेक केयर.